What's the good thing?
The good thing is that this is that even with a chazaka, and the owner knew about it, and the original owner, so we're not talking about the son, because the son...
This occupier of the land came on.
If he on the property of a cotton goes up, if he didn't know that he owned...
Stop. We were talking about... Was he talking about the mission?
And that actually is about doing our husband. And I'm not sure the concept is they're learning
whether or not you're permitted to a relative go into the land and I was a cousin. And even if the, in other words, when we said the language, what is he coming to let us learn?
No, I mean learning.
Nothing.
We learn in our learning.
And nobody should be.
But they don't have any, if somebody for learning Torah should put themselves down.
I think we need God in every... What I'm putting down is my... On the other hand, if you will show me, then they come up, you belong enormous.
But even if you grew up, we might think, if this kid has, when he gets to be 13 years old, and he can't protest, then the person who's trying to make this, it's no good. Protest it. So even if he grows up, I won't understand that. Even if he grows up, that's the...
Even the kid I was thinking, even if he becomes now 13 years in one day, he cannot protest this thing. You still can't start the chazaka, even if the chazaka, this guy started sitting on the field and using the field when the kid became a gadol, because nothing is in one day, okay? And the guy starts, and then he sits until he might not know that his father owns the son of the brother. If he doesn't know, the whole thing is that he doesn't know that his father owned that land. So even though even with him being a gadol, that doesn't make it that the person who's occupying the land can have a chazaka on it.
It's like a shot cradle.
Right.
Oh, but he couldn't get through.
Yeah, that's it.
Okay, my question is, then what if a person knew he owned?
No, he's in the same position as a person. It seems to me that's the way they're learning. So far we've said that he has to be able to profile.
Can I have a question?
It's where he was for you. During the beginning of the
afternoon would learn the way I'm saying it. What I'm saying is that it would seem to take away his land.
Yeah. Because I don't know what I am.
See, I'm saying that a little bit more of it's true, but I'm saying you can stay there and accept the truth.
Yeah. Other people, you know. Yeah. Still teaching Blackness?
No.
Continue from that point out. Here. And here you're making angels all over the place.
We'll get the
angel pastor.
Atlas level 5. Okay. He used the land for 2 years in the presence of who previously had all. Presumably, that previously, 2 years in his presence. We're going to talk about what it means in his presence and not in his presence.
2 years. This was occupying the land. For 2 years, I wasn't even here.
For example, why wasn't he in the presence of the one? Kibara, he ran away. So the man now asked the question. Why did this person, who presumably previously owned the land, who's not in the land now, why did he run away? Why did he run away? If he ran away because he had a run for his life, because the government had a death decree on him, they had a run for his death. Pshita, the law of Mahema, it's simple. Who is now occupying the land should not be believed, the law of Mahema, because the one who ran away for his life, so for that third year, he shouldn't be believed. Okay, because the person who ran away didn't have a chance to... You eat the bar, if he ran away because of money matter, because some people owe a lot of people money. In this case, it wouldn't have been a death penalty if he would protest. Like, you know, he could protest, and he should have protested. And if he didn't protest, just because he ran away because of money matters, the person who's occupying the land shall suffer, because we could say he should have protested this thing. It's his land, so he should have protested it. Since he didn't protest, it should be a chazaka. Be him right, because we have a rule.
Time of we're learning a general
that protesting, not in the presence of the person who's occupying the field, is considered a machlokes, considered a protest, even though he's not in the person's presence.
You would think that the only time that a protest of a person that a former, so-called former owner would help is he's coming right in front of the guy there and says, you are an interloper. You are an interloper. You would think that's the only way it would be effective. You don't have to have the protest in front of the guys occupying the field. You could making a protest not directly to the person who's occupying the field, and it's still effective to stop.
But if you make that protest where two witnesses are in the hearing of two witnesses where they can carry the carrier's message to the land that person.
And there the farmers really run away. I mean, he had to and stay here for a year. Before the year is up, he has two witnesses here. He says, I probably is not there. And we say
there are three lands inside the land of Israel. If a person protests in one of those lands about a person who's occupying the field, and another person who is occupying the field cannot make a chazaka claim.
There's three areas in the land of Israel. And the farmers in the other one of the areas, even protests in the other area, it's still good to stop the, in the opposite. He's protesting in the same area.
Yeah, the same thing. Okay, this now, because we learned this. Three states protesting is in another state. The ones occupying the land cannot make a fuss because they live in two different states. There are three such states. Uda, which is the state and brother Eric, it's like where Jordan, present day Jordan would be now. Jordan, the other side of the Jordan. It's divided, Israel divided into these states. If the person who is talking to walk through Popa is in Yehuda, the southern Israel, and the one who's trying to take possession by is in northern Israel, Baruch, in a chazaka. If they live in two different states, Ashihei with Medina, until they're in the same state, about being in the same state, if they're in two different cities, let's say, in the same state, like in Chicago and Springfield, if they're in the same state, then if the one who's making a protest is in Chicago, and the one who's
and he's the wealthy, that means nobody can disturb it.
You can do it. And what about the case you're doing?
And come with me, and you're not making it only dependent on whether or not exterior circumstances that he doesn't.
If he says, we are not in the presence of
out of the same city, the same state, why all of a sudden you're making some kind of a difference?
If you're going to say that protesting is not in the presence of the one who is not considered, it's not considered a
word, and understand that a protest does not have to be in the interloper. The city can be in the next state. But if you say that it makes a difference if it's different, then that if he's not actually in the different city, in the state, what's the stop of the... You've got to make up your mind. Not in the presence of the one right. You can only make a presence of the man. Protest doesn't have to be in the presence of the man, or does it have to be in the presence of the man? You don't have to be in the presence to protest.
We have to learn that...
Why did you have to learn that? You just understand that if you... What does it make? What is it? Same state, different state. It still should be considered good because of the kings,
where it says that you have to be, if you're in different states, it's not a chassid. They're learning at the time when there's a cutoff in communication between states. There's a cutoff in commerce between the states. So therefore, if somebody were to make we cannot be sure that we travel to the other state because there's a cutoff in communication and commerce.
I'll give you an example of that. Yes. And you can't get easily to, you have to pass the checkoff point. They got to make sure that they're not considered like that you can easily complete the cutoff of all travel from city to the other, then definitely, the mere fact that he is a problem will not affect what the person is, the guy is stuck by virtue of the lack of time. You understand that?
Going to say that just if there's a cut-off in communication between places, it will not effectuate this chazaka. If there's no cut-off, there's a cut-off in communication, then this law would apply.
That you can't?
Yeah. Your answer is, Tom, you would have been Golo to Shasher and Gomel. That when the Mishnah mentions Yehuda and Golo without any explanations, it's talking by the time when they were cut off between states. So it's telling us that this was like a, this is the law in a time when there's a communication cutoff between the two states.
When it's very difficult.
In a time of communication cutoff.
To be able to travel.
We could learn. Okay, now we're learning more. Now we're going to try to take Rabbi Yeshua made a simple statement. He says, if it's a field work, and I bought it from him, then we say he's believed. Different kinds of other things, other kinds of properties, whether
it's... We establish him being a mother. We establish that he is able to be accepted over any other adverse place, not only in relation to real estate, but also considerations to personal property.
Look up there when somebody says to his friend, I'll from you $100. I borrowed $100 from you. And I paid it back to you. Now, you see from this statement that he believed in that case, which said, you see in this case where it says I borrowed money from you, and I, that's the same way I learned on the back previously, where he said, and I borrowed, just in the case when he said, it's a tremendous credit because the person himself maybe doesn't remember this thing or whatever it is. So we were saying, well, how could it be that somebody buys property?
Say again what you're saying. I was looking at something else.
Okay.
Now say it again. Please forgive me.
Okay. In this case where it says, you owned this, I'm saying, I borrowed money from you and I paid it back to you. Show Nama, he believed. The case previous stuff said, this field, I bought it from you, it belonged to you, and then I bought it from you.
And he says like this, Pashto now, co-psychodactyl, we're taking the person's money with witnesses. You've got to have proof